How you doing?
Beautiful, you know, this, you know, this is summer season in the UK and it's really bent and bitter things and we're occupied to the tightening bend, you know?
Yeah, for real. So, let the people out there know, who is Scratchylus?
Well, Scratchylus is the artist, I mean, singing and uplifting and promoting conscious music. See, it's a musical education and around the world, you know?
Yeah.
But I've been based in Jamaica for the last 6-7 years, since 2011, working with the likes of Kinesai and Scissor County and Jewelry, you know, and Inner the Yard Band and a few things, you know?
Yeah, for real. So where did that name come from?
Well, briefly, everyone always asked it. Briefly, when I was younger, on a Friday, we used to go to our house, and I just put on a record.
Okay.
And one of the time it was Scratch. My brother's name is Scratchy. And then from them time they put a loss on it, so it's just Scratchy loss. So that's very simple.
Yeah. Okay. So when did you start getting into music?
Well, from about long time, but from my mother's been playing music on a Sunday morning while she's cooking the Sunday rice and peas.
Okay.
I love music from them time, you know?
Yeah, for real. So why did you choose reggae music?
I mean, reggae music is the music of love. It fights against injustice. That's the main reason.
Okay.
I love reggae music. It fights against injustices. I think it's the only music that really, really penetrates the injustice. It comes from injustice. The people then resonate around because of the injustices of the things, the atrocities around the world. So we highlight them as artists, you know? And we put a heavy bass line. You know, reggae music have a heavy bass line.
Yeah.
So we highlight the message and put a heavy bass line around it and chant. Chant down Babylon, you know?
Yeah, for real. So what latest music have you got coming out?
I've got, at the moment, you know, I mean, I've been reset the mindset, that's going on and on and on. My latest song at the moment is Rebel, with Barry Ford, do you understand?
Yeah.
And it's all in the same line of rebelling against all the atrocities like the Grenfell and Windrush and Donald Trump and all atrocities around the world, you know what I mean? Everywhere, you know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
Even in England.
So, I understand.
Maybe I should give the listeners a live piece right now. What do you say?
Yeah,
sure. DJKat, big up yourself. I'm on Rock Radio. This is Scratchylus. I'm going to say, no loose change, no short change, no drug change. DJKat, rebelling. I said, no loose change, no short change, no drug change. I'm on Rock Radio, rebelling. I'm on Rock Radio, listen up. Well then, missing again. No job vacancies, leading to delinquencies, lies, aggression and oppression, and again, the whole wide world sees, grenfell atrocities, inhumane policies, insensitive hypocrisies, leading to brutal decisions. That's why missing the loose change, the short change, the job change. DJKat, rebellion. I know how to reset the mindset, you know?
For real. Bless up. So, I understand you do a lot of duos with your daughter.
Yes, man. Big up Empress Reggae, you mean?
Yeah.
I've done Our Story with my daughter and Scissor County. My daughter's been in Jamaica with me working very hard. We've also toured universities of the UK, such as Oxford, Liverpool, Bath, Bournemouth, Sowers. We haven't been to Coventry. We might be coming to Coventry this year, Black History Month in October.
Okay, yeah, man. So tell us a little something about that. How did it come about, you and your daughter doing
that? Well, I'm in Jamaica, and my music is education, DJ, do you understand?
Yeah.
We do with intellectual music, and so my thing is we have to go into the places where people are receiving, and we do questions and answers and things like that in universities. But you know, universities have critical thinkers, and they look at things, they analyse things, and digest things, and then they ask the questions, and we get to tell them, and they get to hear it from the real thing. You know what I'm saying?
For real, yeah. So, what's your thoughts on the current state of reggae music at the moment?
Well, reggae music can always be alive, you know, from those injustices around the world, and from those things that need to be highlighted, and people need to be made aware. Reggae music is the right platform, so we love reggae music all around the world.
What would you say to young people who want to get involved in music?
Yeah, well, if you want to get into music, the first thing I tell you is to try and do live music. All of my music I do is with live music. It's not on computer or your bedroom music. It's every song, every note is played by a musician, the live drum, with the live music.
Yeah.
The reason why I say that, because as an artist, you learn from you and working with live musicians. You learn how to perform on stage. You understand how to do your melodies, and you understand how the harmonies go. So when you perform into the crowd, you can have you're more sensitive to the crowd feelings, with the vibes,
you know? Okay, yeah, definitely. What events have you got coming up that the people can see you at?
I've just done two events. The Notting Hill Carnival Pioneer, they can see that on Facebook. I've done the Queen's Park Festival. I've got Brixton, Kennington Park. That's in on Saturday. Then after that, you know, the Notting Hill Carnival, Goulburn Gallery with DJ Groovemaster, R&B DJ that is as far as rap attack. And, you know, we're trying to spread this message in all fields and all genders right now, you know?
Yeah. Are you at one?
Keep up the link, yeah?
Yeah, man, for real. All right.
That's just all right.
Blessings.